Welcome back to American Latino TV. I'm your host, Valerie Ortiz. Legendary guitarist Carlos Alomar has played with musical greats, including Chuck Berry, Paul McCartney, Mick Jagger, Alicia Keys, and Bruno Mars, just to name a few. However, it is his longtime friendship and experience serving as David Bowie's musical director that really shaped his place in music history. Today, we hear about how this Puerto Rican rocker has used his fame to provide other Latino artists a place in the ever-evolving rock music landscape. Check it out.
I am the son of a Pentecostal minister. That's where, at 10 years old, he gave me my first guitar. When my father died at 14 years old, he gave me his blessing, and that's where I went to the Apollo Theater to seek my fortune. For me to find myself as a young lad in the Apollo Theater was amazing. It was like God sent to be put in a place like that where I could be influenced by all those people. I mean, I got to play with James Brown, with Wilson Pickett, with Chuck Berry. I mean, I'm talking about the icons of American history. This was early 70s when I met this young Brit that had come to America, David Bowie. Slashback blazers and ate all your razors while pulling the waiters. I started influencing him by introducing him to all the Latin music that he had heard about, all the, you know, the acts of the Apollo Theater, which later proved fruitful when we did our first album together, Young Americans, in 1974. It is amazing to think that an individual from London can come over here with a life dream of doing soul music, prepare this album in such a way that he creates a template for what is soul music. I think that, to his credit, it is an amazing man that can do such an amazing thing. In fact, it gave him his first number one hit, which I co-wrote with David Bowie and John Lennon. I mean, imagine, a kid from Puerto Rico, the first record that I ever write is with David Bowie and John Lennon. I mean, to be sandwiched between those two icons is just amazing. My Latin pride forces me to say, Carlos, when are you gonna do something for your people? I was introduced to a group that was just starting out called Soda Stereo. Soda Stereo is an amazing rock band from Argentina. And listen, I produced their record, Doble Vida. Well, let me tell you, Doble Vida ended up being their gigantic explosion record. And the explosion of rock and español is apparent to this day. You know, I look at the impact that technology has in my work at Stevens, and what I find is this new brand of musician really amazes me. This is that ice cold Michelle fight for that white gold. This one for them hood girls, them good girls, straight masterpieces. But I am so grateful for the phone calls that I've gotten. Because look, my name appears in the Library of Congress. I've got 32 to 35 gold records. I'm gonna get another one for the Bruno Mars stuff. Don't believe me, just watch. You know how long it's taken me to get to the point where I'm looking at the television and saying hello to my people in Puerto Rico? That's how amazing my life is. That towards the end of it, it's just beginning.